So I wanted to talk about, you know, the gear that I use to do my work, obviously photography and video. I think the cameras that I started on was Canon 650D. I think I got it right, 650D with a flip out screen. That camera was amazing. It taught me a whole lot of things that I know about photography. In fact, everything that I know about photography. And I got to refine my skills and my knowledge on the other cameras that I jumped to as I progressed and developed and grown into, you know, my field. But the 650D is the camera that really gave me an experience of photography and video. I got to shoot my first documentary on that camera. I got to shoot my first corporate photography on that camera. I'll forever, you know, be appreciative of the experience that I got from that camera. And I still respect anyone that has got a very small Nyana camera, you know, small in terms of not having the capabilities of a professional camera, you know, but still be able to do amazing work out there. Because at the end of the day, it's not the camera, it is you, the artist, the crafter. What are you bringing to the world? Clients don't see that you shot on this specific camera. The clients see results, and it's important. When you do your work, you know exactly what you're doing. You get what I'm saying? And then from the 650, I felt like I needed an upgrade. You get what I mean? I guess I was growing to be a Canon loyalist, and then I jumped to the Mark II, 5D Mark II, which I think was a fabulous, you know, camera. It was an amazing camera, you know, until it got stolen. I'll post up the story. Yeah, but wherever it is, I hope the person that is using it is really getting the best out of it, because it'll be a great disappointment to myself, even the engineers that engineer their camera, to be in the hands of people who don't know how to appreciate the masterpiece that camera is. The Canon 5D was stolen, and I got to shoot some stuff, of course, on it, right? Photography and video. Shot amazing stuff with it, stuff that I still look at right now and say, you know what, I've made some major progress, so really appreciate it. I jumped on to Nikon, yo, I think I spent a whole lot of time with Nikon cameras, more than I did with Canon, that I started being a Nikon loyalist. But along the way, I kind of figured out that you cannot be a loyalist to a particular camera brand. All that is cameras that are doing work and you direct it, you know what I mean? You tell the camera what to do, and eventually the results that come out of there, it's your decision, it's not the camera's decision. So that's why sometimes it's quite confusing, and you need to educate people a little bit that when you carry a big camera like this, they think, yo, must you doing big stuff? No, no, no. And when you got a small camera like that, you know, they think, ah, this camera, ah, my guy, come on. Some of these people don't even understand the basics of those cameras and how these cameras are being made nowadays. Cameras can be the same size and not have the same capability. You get what I'm saying? So, at the end of the day, I shot some good stuff with Nikon, you know? Great photography with Nikon, great, you know, corporate photography with Nikon, great personal stuff, fashion, all of these things, you know, you mentioned them, you know? I did some great stuff that was admired by people who are doing great stuff as well. You know what I mean? Ended up shooting video on it. I shot an advert on it, the Amasi advert. I shot this advert on the D750, you know, which was great. You get what I mean? I also shot another one, a grandpa advert. My opinion about Nikon cameras, the ones that I used, is that they were great in terms of photography and video, but I think from my experience, I know people will say Nikon is good in photography, video and whatnot, but from my experience, I can actually confirm that Nikon, when it comes to pictures, don't fucks with it, right? Video wise, it was good, and I did stuff that is quite, you know, amazing as well, because like I said, sometimes it's not the camera, it's just you, you know? But I also realized that I've used the camera to their limits. Never change a camera without having used it to its limits, where you feel like I'm limited, I wanna do 1, 2, 3, 4, and now I gotta upgrade. Upgrade because you are limited by your camera, not because there's a new camera that is out. You get what I'm saying? So I used up those cameras, had two cameras, Nikon D750, Nikon D810. Came a time where I felt in terms of video, they are limiting me because they were 1080 and the highest frame rate was 60p. At some point, I had to do stuff for clients that really needed like proper, you know, resolutions and stuff like that. When it comes to pictures, no doubt, hands down, Nikon will show you flames. I looked around and I was like, maybe I should go back to Canon because I know Canon is also capable. But the cameras that I saw were a little bit more capable in terms of, you know, video at a reasonable price, not necessarily reasonable because they're still expensive, was Fuji. I looked at Fuji and the price range really, I think, pulled me to them. And also what these cameras are capable of, they're pretty nice small cameras, but never underestimate the work that comes out of these cameras. They're magic. I jumped from Nikon, went to Fuji. Nikon was limiting me because it was shooting 1080 60 frames per second as the highest frame rate, and I needed to do your slow mo's and very nice stuff that I was visualizing when I was crafting and planning my stuff, you know, whether doing a commercial or shooting documentary. There's certain things that I needed to express the emotions in a different way, and those Nikons were limiting me. I looked at Sony was expensive for me. Capable cameras, wonderful cameras. I looked at Canon. The higher range Canon cameras was a little bit expensive as well. I saw Fuji, amazing cameras. I've never used Fujis before. I saw some guys that were using Fuji and I used them as reference in terms of the quality that I can get from there. And when I went to research, before I bought these cameras, I researched deeply about them. And I found out they shoot, you know, 4K at 60 frames per second. That is crazy. A whole lot of cameras don't shoot 4K 60 frames per second. Yes, they might shoot 4K, but maybe 4K at 24 frames per second or 25 frames per second. But this crazy beast, 4K at 60 frames per second. Although I don't shoot 4K 60 frames per second on these cameras, but they were pretty much capable in terms of the higher resolution standards. So these are the cameras, right? And I also needed slow-mo. So these cameras can go up to 120 frames per second. And I looked around Sony's, I looked around, you know, other cameras and stuff. I'm like, these cameras are unable to do what this camera is able to do. And yet it's so much affordable than those cameras. Maybe it's because we're buying brands, you know, people are loyal to brands.
I'm not a brand loyalist. So, like I said, you know, it doesn't mean that a year later I'll still be upgrading to another Fuji or whatever. If I see another camera that offers me something better, I'll probably jump onto that camera. Whether it's secondhand, whether it's brand new. If it's brand new, if I can afford it, of course, I'll buy it. If I can't afford it, I can find a secondhand that I can afford. Most definitely, I'll buy it. I'm after the work that the camera can do rather than the name. You know what I mean? I'm not brand loyal. I'm my work loyal. I'm loyal to my style. You get what I mean? So if that camera can help me achieve the style that I wanna achieve, I'm with that camera. No matter the hype that is put out there by the media or advertising, you know, agencies or whatever, YouTube or YouTubers that review cameras and say this camera is the best, whatever. Maybe they're getting paid out of it. You know what I mean? Maybe not. They're not getting paid. Maybe it's because it's a particular type of look and style that they're after, that they recommend those cameras to you. You get what I'm saying? But for my type of work, documentary and all of that, and some type of photography that I do, Fuji for me is doing that magic for me. And for now, I'm just enjoying, you know, the benefits of my labor that helped me get these cameras. You get what I'm saying? So yeah, that's that, man. Plus on here I've got this lens, the T, the 24 mil T 1.5, the same young. It's doing great work in terms of, you know, the wide type of, you know, compositions that I'd like to achieve, and getting closer, because the focal length on this camera, I can put it right next to my eye like this, it'll still be in focus for those who are technical and understand what cameras, you know, how cameras operate. You get what I'm saying? Some cameras you put it this close and the lens will not be able to achieve a focus on that. So that's why I'm loving this very special baby right here. I've got other lenses that I use, you know, which are amazing, help me do the great work that I'm doing. You know, they're not expensive. Some of them are not really expensive, you get what I'm saying? I buy vintage lenses if I can find them, and with a good reason, of course, in mind. Why am I buying this camera? Why am I buying this lens? Not because it's cheap, not because it's popular, because it can do what I want it to do. I've got a Minolta lens right here. This is a 50mm 1.4. The reason I bought this lens is because it's a low light lens and very lightweight. And right here, I've got my Nikon here. This is a vintage lens. Those who knows lenses will tell you right away, this is a very vintage, you know, looking lens. Not just the looks, but in terms of the works as well. The glass, it's amazing. There's something magical about vintage lenses, and I couldn't stay away from them. I got myself this vintage, you know, 50mm 1.4 fast lens. You know, it's a manual lens, obviously, and the one that I just had right now is a manual lens, so it's quite amazing. And here I've got the 18-55 f/2.8 FUJI Beast. This is a kit lens, but it does amazing things. This lens is super expensive. It's a very small lens, but it's expensive, guys. It's a very expensive lens. I won't even give prices on this lens. Some of them, they just, you know, rip me apart just to mention the price. So yeah, that's what it is. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in into this channel right here, man. I really appreciate your time, for sticking around. See you on the next one. Really appreciate it.